So, the current season of Fortnite is coming to a close. There's only a couple of weeks remaining before season 10 arrives on August 1st. Are you ready? If we've learned anything from seasons past, there's likely going to be some big changes being made to the item and weapon meta. While nothing has been leaked just yet, additions and removals being made to the map is pretty much guaranteed, guys. And being able to master these changes quickly can give you a big advantage during the first few weeks of the season. So don't forget to head over to proguides.com to vote on the game's current weapon meta. Hey, you never know. There could be some major changes to the list come season 10, for better or worse. What up, guys? This is your guy, Keith Allen. And today, hey, we're gonna be teaching you how to prepare for season 10. It's about to go down. There are so many changes happening to the competitive Fortnite, likely after the World Cup. So to be better prepared, we're gonna tell you which game modes and practice regimens will help prepare you for the incoming changes. All right, so first of all, it looks like as if it's gonna be a whole variety of new competitive events. The main ones so far being trios. Epic Games is trying out trios in a competitive setting for the first time, and so far the results are pretty good. So it seems that a lot of pros are liking the trios format. The amount of coordination and teamwork needed is much higher than other modes, and it's leading to a lot of fresh and exciting games. There's been some shakeups in who's teaming up with who as well. For example, at least this previous weekend, Tfue didn't play with Cloaksy in Trios Cash Cup. He grouped with Klix and Sway last second. The community was pretty surprised to see him go with completely new teammates. But with World Cup ending, now is the time to explore new opportunities for many of these guys. So with new rosters being formed, it's going to be very interesting to see which teams end up dominating the upcoming tournaments. With such great reception to the format, hey, we're likely going to start seeing trio events run a lot more in the future. Adding a third member into the mix definitely makes trios require more teamwork and coordination than ever before. That's something you can't learn instantly. It can take some time to synergize and play well with teammates, all right? Who's played with teammates before? Whether it's fighting off spawn or rotating in the endgame, the approach in trios and squads is much different than other modes. For instance, I mean, since loot has to be shared, you're less likely to get what you need in larger modes. And we're already seeing how some pro teams are reacting to this. During early game looting, some teams are splitting up with ballers in order to cover more ground and gather more loot. Yeah, it's risky, but it helps with getting each player the items and materials they need. So, in the end game, players are coming up with clever ways to get more use out of their mobility items. With so many different healing and mobility items, inventory management becomes much more important. Knowing which heals, weapons, mobility items, and materials are being held by your teammates is a must, guys. Learning to check this diligently comes with practice. If you spend enough time in a team setting, you'll start communicating more effectively and start seeing better results. Epic Games also confirmed that 4-player squad events are coming soon as well. Ooh, that should be cool. And we're not even used to trios yet. This is looking to get a bit insane, but in a good way. Larger game modes are likely going to see bigger roles in tournaments, and you're probably going to want to find a team to practice with ASAP. In a recent Ask Me Anything on Reddit, Fortnite developers hinted at some changes coming to upcoming tourneys. First, platform-specific tournaments are confirmed to be coming soon. Recently, there was a leak on Xbox advertising a $1 million prize pool solo tournament exclusive to players on Xbox. Looking at that, hey, it seems as if Epic is planning some tournaments exclusive to each platform. We're probably going to see PS4, Nintendo Switch, and EVO Mobile tournaments just like this revealed soon. Non-PC players did have a really hard time making it to the finals of each qualifier week. Playing on a controller is a lot tougher than a keyboard and mouse. And it doesn't help that if you're not on a PC, your game won't run well in stacked endgames. So, even if you're one of the best mobile players in the world, qualifying in the same tournaments as PC players likely won't happen. I'm sorry, just being real. Now, players on weaker platforms will have a chance to earn some money and make a name for themselves within their respective platforms. You know, it should be interesting to watch how they play out though, especially a mobile tournament. So when asked their opinions on Arena and the future of competitions, Epic Games said, "We are currently working on a refresh of Arena, with an emphasis around providing more high quality, exciting matches and tournaments with meaningful stakes. Hype will become more like a currency which you'll use to enter tournaments and participate in higher difficulty arena matches, with top overall performers for the season represented on a leaderboard. Seasonal rewards are on the roadmap as well for future iterations of Arena. We also want to get back to running nightly tournaments on a regular basis across a wider variety of team sizes and game modes. Having hype as rewards for placements in these tournaments will help provide some meaning and motivation behind each competition, even when cash isn't on the line. So it seems, guys, that there might be a rework to the ranking system coming soon. Either a complete rework of how you gain and lose points will happen, or they'll simply add more divisions and make tweaks to the matchmaking to create better matches at higher ratings. Beyond that, they're going to be higher tier tournaments that require more rating to enter. Hey, it looks as if just being in Division 7 won't cut it in the future. Seasonal rewards are a neat thing to have as well. It's likely to be the form of some skin like a glider, back bling, or pickaxe. But you never know what they'll decide to give out as a reward. Maybe even some V-Bucks. Some games with competitive seasons perform rank resets in between them, which lower your rank. Having to earn back rating provides more incentive to play, so would it be a bad concept to implement? Epic hasn't said if they'll do that just yet, but it's always a possibility. While a lot of what Epic said was kind of vague, hopefully the Arena rework and introduction of competitive seasons will provide more reasons for players to grind. So with the ranking system's possibly incoming change looming ahead, keeping an open mindset, guys, is just as important as practicing your in-game skills. So don't always rely on what worked for you in the past. For instance, if you got to Champs Division in Arena 3 months ago because you used ballers when they had 300 HP, you might have a harder time climbing again now that they only have half the health. If you end up struggling to climb after a rank reset, that can be an indicator, guys, to change things up. Regardless of any meta changes, hey, in Battle Royale, your safest bet is usually just to play for placement so you can climb in rating. But hey, it may not be the Battle Royales you have to prepare for going into Season 10. When asked about potentially adding competitive modes that aren't Battle Royale, Epic gave this answer. We are definitely considering all kinds of possibilities when it comes to alternate competitive modes outside of Battle Royale. We have plans to continue to expand creative modes so players can create their own favorite version of Fortnite. We'll be closely monitoring these community-created competitive modes as the tools for creative mode expand, and we'll officially support some of the more popular ones that pop up over time. So, based on that answer, it wouldn't be too far off potentially to see new competitive LTMs being put out next season. The most popular competitive modes people in creative right now are those that simulate in-game. Outside of custom matches, there isn't really a way to get good practice for the in-game. Being able to grind in-games has been requested by the competitive community for quite some time now. Cross your fingers, it looks like as if Epic is paying close attention to these requests, so maybe we'll probably see a mode in that variety coming out soon. 1v1s are also pretty popular right now. It's a preferred method of practice and warm-up among many pro players, like Dubs, Mongrel, and Clicks. You see those guys in creative having build fights all the time. And also, hey, it seems like some players just don't like Battle Royale much anymore. Hey, you never know, Epic might see this and come out with a competitive versus mode that's similar to 1v1, but maybe with the option for 2v2s or 4v4s. What creative modes do you want to see Epic officially support next season? Hey, leave us your answer in the comments below. I'm curious to see what you're going to say. So speaking of creative, let's talk about why the mode is so good for learning and why you should be playing it. So when it comes down to learning and perfecting mechanics, the practice most pros prefer can be found in creative mode. Battle Royale can have a lot of downtime throughout the match, okay? The level of practice you get in it is just isn't extreme as it could be. Sometimes you want to build battle with infinite mats or just grind out in-game simulations. Hey, that way you can learn and become better at a much faster pace than by playing Battle Royale. Epic has been adding a bunch of settings in creative lately, and so people's creations are just much more sophisticated than they used to be. Right now, Zone Wars is one of the best ways to get right into a competitive in-game simulation. YouTuber Enigma released a new Zone War map recently, featuring additions like randomized loadouts, changes in elevation, and material you can just harvest throughout the level. So we'll leave a link to this video in the comments so you can just check it out once you're done with this one. If you don't have anyone to build battle or play Zone Wars with, hey, there's always warm-up levels you can play solo. We had a video on this not too long ago that's still useful to watch if you haven't already. Hey, check it out here. For those that strive to get better or just find themselves stuck at a certain point, you know, grinding out some practice in creative is just one of the best ways to improve. Trust me, guys. Gotta practice. There's just a level of practice in there that you just can't get by playing Battle Royale all the time. So we highly, highly recommend getting together with some friends, hang out, and just get into a build battle, play some Zone Wars, and all around just get better at the game. The last portion just before our video ends includes some tips on learning the new additions to the game. Of all the changes Epic Games makes each season, the two most impactful and important ones to learn are map changes and weapon changes. Every single season, some sort of change occurs to the map. New points of interest gets added, and that's just something you can take advantage of. Knowing a zone inside and out gives you a big edge when it comes to looting, farming material, and just fighting opponents. That's why so many pro players land at the same spot in their matches, guys, so they can just perfect their knowledge of the area. When a new zone gets added, some players prefer just to drop in and check out a new area in a BR mode. But honestly, if you really want to learn a new spot when Season 10 arrives, you should check it out in Creative mode. You usually don't get a good chance to learn a spot thoroughly while in an actual match. So many players will land there, especially when it first gets released. Trying to learn things at the same time while getting sprayed by this guy with a drum gun can be quite difficult. In creative mode, hey, you can take your time. You'll be able to experience things uninterrupted, which should allow you to learn much more efficiently than in actual matches. There's also 100% spawn rate on loot on the map in creative, so you can also know for certain where every chest is. Then, hey, you can figure out which specific parts of the zone have higher concentrations of loot or material for you to land by. After you learn any specific zones, hey, spend some time discovering all the other changes. Usually, Epic adds some sort of new mobility on the map each season, like slipstreams in Season 9. It's important to learn the rotation paths of your favorite zones using these so that you don't misuse them in endgame. So, what about any new items? Huh? Well, you can just mess around with these in creative mode as well. Quickly just learning things like damage values or any unique mechanics behind them. But really, hey, most of your expertise with a certain item will come from practical usage. When in a match, don't be afraid of using a weapon in-game even when you're unfamiliar with it. Especially, guys, when you're unfamiliar with it. When the combat shotgun was released, alright, so many players immediately thought it was terrible. The problem was is that they didn't understand that the value of the combat shotgun came from its much longer range capabilities. Eventually, the player base figured it out, and the weapon was deemed overpowered. So we're sure some players were able to figure it out how good the combat shotgun was sooner than others, just by sticking through it and just testing the new weapon. Another example is the drum shotgun. Just by looking at the stats, it seems like it's an alright weapon, okay? Doesn't seem that special. But if you really get into point-blank range of your enemy, whew, that drum shotgun will shred. It has one of the lowest times to kill out of all the shotguns. But in practical usage, there are more things to consider. Like, not every player will allow you to get within point-blank range of them, alright? That's just reality. They're gonna build, they're gonna block shots, and reposition when they can. Early game shotgun ammo is rare, and the drum shotty uses a lot of it. Also, the fire rate is so fast, landing every shot on moving opponents might be too difficult. Basically, hey, guys, there are a lot more consideration when it comes to learning an item or weapon than when it comes to learning the layout of a map. While, hey, it can be useful to just get the gist of a weapon in creative mode, practical use against real opponents will allow you to understand it the most. Without more exact details on the upcoming season, it's hard just to say what exactly you should do to prepare. We just saw our first Trios tournament happen recently, and it's likely that squads are coming soon after. With Epic Games looking at creative modes to see what is popular among the creative community, we might soon see some variation of Zone Wars or Versus style matchmaking modes added soon. For those that want to get a head start, now's your chance. Hey, over on our website, guys, we have InstaPro, which allows you to instantly hook up with a coach, which is so cool, and they can just help guide you through any gameplay problems you're having. These guys, hey, they know the game like the back of their hand, man. They'll teach you any new tips and tricks and walk you through the variety of changes that occur. So, head over to ProGuys.com right now to check out InstaPro, guys. You'll love it. Hey, guys, once again, hey, this is your boy Keith Allen, and I've been enjoying just the community, man, that we have. So, send me a message, follow me on my Instagram. We got more videos coming out. Got any questions? Holla at your boy. We'll talk to you soon.